Joining us this afternoon in advance of the Blue-Emu Maximum Pain Relief 500 is a very respected and in-depth reporter from The Athletic. Please welcome Jeff Gluck. Hi, Jeff. Good to see you.
Hi, Kim. Yeah, good to see you too, virtually, but that's the best we can do these days, right?
Right, exactly, because things are wildly different today than the last time we saw each other and the last time that NASCAR raced at Martinsville. But NASCAR is back, and this is our seventh race since the return of the sport. How does this play into the greater sports world?
Well, I mean, the other sports are trying to come back, but they haven't been able to pull it together yet, and they're still getting their plans. So that means NASCAR has the spotlight once again. And I'm hoping that, you know, these weeknight races keep becoming a thing because I like watching them. I don't know. There's something I've always wanted to see, weeknight races. And now to see them actually taking place like this, especially the first Martinsville night race. Oh, I wish I was there. But yeah, it's pretty cool.
What do you feel like the racing's been like without fans at the venue?
Well, I think at some of the bigger tracks, you know, you can't really tell, you know, like what the pre-race, the post-race, you're like, oh, wow, that's kind of weird. And then once it gets going, it's sort of the same, you know, the stands go by in a blur anyway. But, you know, at Bristol a couple weeks ago, and, you know, I think tonight at Martinsville, you know, the stands are right there. You can see them. And so it's going to be more obvious that people aren't there. But you also know that means that people are sitting there at home watching every move that's going on.
So it might be a little obvious from an optics perspective, especially if we're watching on TV, but let's be real. Let's look at it from a competitor's perspective. Once these guys are strapped in, the green flag drops, do they even notice the crowd? I mean, certainly during the race, all the focus should be, if you're a driver, on the racetrack. So the idea of no fans, does it really take away from the competition at all?
They have said so far that they don't see it. Like, they wouldn't normally see it anyway, apparently. I think that their comments have been stuff like, and this could very well happen at Martinsville, where somebody gets into like a little scuffle afterwards, or there's some disagreement. And normally you would think the fans are going to be like showering somebody with boos or cheers or reacting. And all the drivers are standing there on pit road afterwards and it's quiet. So I think that's where they notice. But as far as being in the car, the competition, there's really no difference.
Yeah, I didn't think about that perspective, the crowd reactions, especially when we're at a place like Martinsville, but ultimately the stakes remain the same. They are still going after the same thing.
Yeah, they're still going to get a grandfather clock, right? And the clock doesn't say you won this race with no fans. you're a Martinsville winner. It still chimes the same. That makes more noise than the empty stands might be, but yeah, the stakes are still the same.
Well, it wasn't long ago that you and I would be making guest visits to corporate hospitality tents, interviewing drivers, crew chiefs in the media center, going to the track midways to do tweet ups and fan experiences. And now here we find ourselves on Zoom. It's been unique, to say the least. I know you have a family at home. I've got a puppy. There's a lot of things to juggle. So how has it changed the way that you do your job?
Well, I wish I had a nice background like you do. Here I am in my closet. I have this backdrop that I stole from a patio window thing so that you can't see my dirty laundry in the back. So that's awkward. But aside from that, I mean, I have to tell my wife, hey, I'm going to do a Zoom interview now. Is there possible that you could try to keep our daughter from crying for 15 minutes so that everybody doesn't know that it's like so? But I mean, I guess everybody's used to it, right? You have a lot of people have a lot of grace right now, and they let things slide. So I'm just going with that.
Awesome. Well, back to tonight in the racing. What can we expect to see at the paperclip in terms of the competition and maybe some things to watch out for?
So Martinsville is my favorite racetrack. So I feel like Martinsville always delivers. And, you know, especially now with the short track package back, the lower downforce back at Bristol, I do this, was it a good race poll? It was the highest race rating ever in my poll a couple weeks ago. And Phoenix to start the year with this package. I mean, it was fantastic. So I think that this is going to be a really good race. I think you're going to see people mad at each other, which is what we all love to see. At least I do. Adds the drama of it. And it's going to be good racing. I think that, you know, the restarts are going to be fantastic. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what happens. It's going to be fun.
Absolutely. And they got a new tire too. So that should be interesting.
Yes. Yes. And I don't think they've tested it. So
no. And no practice or qualifying. So
yeah,
let them rip, right?
Yep, exactly.
All right. Got to ask. I know it's the question you always dread when you enter the race weekend, because inevitably somebody's going to ask you, but who do you have taking home the grandfather clock?
I actually don't dread this question just because if I'm right, I can brag about it. And if I'm wrong, nobody will remember at all. Everybody just be like, oh, he was wrong like everybody else. But if I'm right, I can be like, oh, well, on the Blue-Emu pre-race show, I did say. So I'm going to say Brad Keselowski. He's run really well at Martinsville. He seems to stay out of trouble. He's always up front. He may get into a scuffle, but he could also win. And I think he just knows how to get it done there. So I'm going to go with him.
I agree. I'm not just saying that because you picked him, but I did my research earlier in the day, looked at some of the stats. He's my race pick too. So I agree with that.
Look good.
We'll see. Well, hopefully we can go back and say, did you watch us on the Blue-Emu pre-race? And we picked Brad. Yeah. Yep. Awesome. Well, there you have it. Jeff, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it. And we're glad to see you safe and well.
Thank you. You too, Kim. And thanks to you and everybody at Blue-Emu for having me. Appreciate it.